apply mo mga unsa-unsa nga mga position, ma-qualified pud mo, isa ni siya sa nga training nga relevant or ma-count na siya sa mga sa maong training ninyo, no? So ang akong I am assigned to discuss a topic on ethics in the government service. So sa gingon ni Ped na gi-prepare ni daan dito sa secretary sa central office, pero ako na ni siyang daghan man gud kay slide nga murag kapareha lang, ako na lang po ni siyang gi pangdilit aw gi tagalan kay aron dilit pud kayo mataas ang atong istorya, no? So ang atong topic is ethics in the government service. Why do we need ethics in the government service? So first, atong ibawan, we will learn what is ethics and why do we need ethics in the government service. So ethics, ingon diri, the moral principles which determine the rightness or wrongness of particular acts or activities. It is the distinction we make between right and wrong, good and evil in relation to actions, intention, or character. So, awareness ni siya o atong understanding nato sa mga butang or decision nga atong paghimuon, maayo man siya or dili. So, ethics is deciding what is right and doing it. Further explanation sa ethics, ingon diri, the moral principles which determine the rightness or wrongness of particular acts or activities should be, as government servant, it should be a public service ethics. It requires us to give quality service to the public, standards, rules, morals. It's the science of human duty. So, sa ning science of human duty means our moral obligation and responsibility as public servant. Ethics of governance. Good governance is characterized with accountability, transparency, participation, non-discrimination, responsiveness, poverty alleviation. So no need of explanation. Kabalo na kita niini, no? Muna nga ito kasagaran din na-recite during sa ito ang flag ceremony. So next is ethics in the governance, participation rule of law, transparency, responsiveness, consensus, orientation, equity, effectiveness, efficiency, accountability. So unsa ning consensus, orientation. So means everybody is well informed. So diya sa atong pisina, kailangan kabaluta bisan ang ato ang position dili ta pang technical nata sa support. So kailangan kabalo po ta ginagmay kung unsa ang naadina, unsa ang ginahimo sa support, unsa yung mga Republic Act, bisan ginagmay lang yun, at least do na tay knowledge na sa unsay ginahimo or unsay work sa DNR, mga DNR laws and regulations. So dunay we have four ethical bases. One is rules. So as government workers, you have these four ethical bases. Ato ni siyang isa-isahon. Number one is rules as an ethical basis. We believe in them as coming by divine revelation with authority or of our community. So, so kining rule number one, as public servants or government workers, we have rules to abide or follow from national or local government. So ang best example ani is kining rules and regulations nga ginahatag sa tua from IETF, no, nga atong ginapalo. So they have authority to set guidelines, provisions for the welfare and health of the people while we are in this pandemic time. So kailangan ato na siyang ipalo na sa maunga ang maunga mga rules. Next is results. So being on the read, the utilitarian principle focuses our attention on results or the consequences of our actions. It has been expressed traditionally as seeking the greatest good for the greatest number. So a goal put forth by our leaders that they should be judged by the result of their policies and specifically whether those policies benefit the majority. So kini ba ang ginahimo sa ato ang mga leaders, sa ato ang gobyerno, makaayo ba alang sa kadaghanan or pili lang, no, nagahimo sila mga balaod para lang sa ilahang pabor, no. So mo na siya nga kailangan duna ang result, dunay result nga makita nga dapat pang para sa kadaghanan, no, seeking the greatest good for the greatest number para sa kadaghan nga mga katawhan. Next is relationship. So Confucius' golden rule of caring: do not do to others what you would not have them do to you. Jesus Christ's expression of love: in everything, do to others as you would have them do to you. So kini nga golden rule is the principle of treating others as you want to be treated. It is a maxim or saying that is found in most religions and cultures. It can be considered an ethic. So buhata ngadto sa uban ang gusto nimo nga buhaton diha kanimo. No. And if you do this, wala jud gubot, no, sa or walay away bisan sa atong family, sa atong neighbors, o labi na sa ato ang working environment, atong mga office mate. Do not have a good relationship towards others. And the last is tradition as an ethical basis. Traditional ethics, the ethics of earlier generations that is based on tradition. It is right to act in certain way because that is what it has always been done. So people believe, ang tradition is, people believe that these things are right and wrong because other people think that way and they have thought that way for a long time. So muna kasagaran, ato pa ng gikan dito sa atong mga kanunuan, mga lula, lulo, nga muna nilang ginahimo, tumupo na, tumupo na, ginasunod-sunod na to, nga gitudlo na sa ato ang mga katigulangan. Kini atong himuon, kay mauni ang ginahimo sa una. So it is also considered as ethics. Okay, as government servants, you have rules to follow. So, Section 1, Article 11, 1997 Constitution on public office is a public trust. So, public officials and employees must at all times serve the people with utmost responsibility, integrity, loyalty, and efficiency. Act with patriotism and justice and live modest life. And Section 28, beyond the state shall maintain honesty and integrity in the public service and take positive and effective measures against graft and corruption. So, gina-repeat balik-balik yun ni ang word niya, honesty and integrity. It should be para sa mga government workers, government servants. No? So, this afternoon, we will discuss briefly about three Republic Acts. So, kanang mubo lang siya, no? Mao lang nato kung unsa jud ang iyang thought niini. So, one is Republic Act 3019, Anti-Graft and Corrupt Practices Act. Anti-graft law enacted in 1960 rules as an ethical basis. So, graft is defined as the acquisition of gain or advantage by dishonest, unfair, or sordid means, especially through the use of one's position or influence in politics, business, etc. So, ang sordid means, kining marumi or maruming paraan. Na-acquire ni muna ng mga butang nga pinagi sa dili maayo nga pamaagi. So, kaning, muna na, no, sa binuang nga paagi. So, muna na siya, na-under siya sa graft. So, graft and corruption is an act or omission involving breach of the rules of decency, honesty, and efficiency for the purpose of obtaining undue advantage at the expense of the government-owned resources. In our legal system, graft and corruption is basically a crime. So, murag makuan po tanong kay ibutang diri, graft and corruption is basically a crime. Pero nga nung daghan magpunta tayo ma madumog o makita nga ginapraktis. So, dapat dili siya, dapat timuon. Especially sa kanang mga model unta ang mga government servants. So ang corruption is an act done with an intent to give some advantage inconsistent with official duty and the rights of others. It includes bribery, but it is more comprehensive because an act may be corruptly done through the advantage to be delivered from it but not offered by another. Is the perversion or destruction of integrity, of fidelity in discharging public duties and responsibilities by bribery or favor. It entails the use of public power for private advantage in ways which transgresses some formal rule of law. So, kining daghan man gud, no, labi na diri sa siguro natay mga kaning young ones pa, mga bago pa lang sa serbisyo na atong participants karon. So atong akong gina-advise sa inyo ha nga kaning take good care of your name. Importante ang ato ang pangalan. Do not tie ka na kung mahawa man ta sa opisina, mahinungduman kita nga kita dunay maayo nga binuhatan sa opisina. So kay kining corruption is the abuse of entrusted power for private gain by bribery or suhulan. Himuoni-muoni kay tabangan na ka na ko o nawatan ni director ng pero madali ng papili. So ato nang ato bili na to na siya eh, practice dapat. Atong himuan ang atong part sa office or asa tanga ang work kanang with integrity, no? So giingon gani ako jud ning ginamention diya sa Book of Solomon, giingon a good name is rather to be chosen than silver and gold. So ato ang preserve ang atong integrity kay ngano kanang bisan wala na bitaw ta sa office, nang retire na ta o wala na ta ni ang kalibutan, and then ang mga tao ma-remember ta nila nga maayo na siya. So kung doon naman tayo mga anak or apo nga nag-working na nga ilang mahinumduman kung kinsa ang ilang lola na nag-work sa una niya o lolo, kaning maayo bitaw ang legacy nga imong na nabilin sa mga office. So ingon nila, material things will just vanish, pero ang magandang gawin mo hindi malimutan kahit wala ka na sa opisina o sa mundo nito. So that is under graft and corruption. Okay, next RA is 6713. So rules 10, kini na lang ang akong emphasize ang may check ha. Recommending any person to any position. By the way, ang RA 6713 is Code of Conduct and Ethical Standard of Government Officials and Employees. So, kining we check, you're recommending any person to any position in a private enterprise which has a regular or pending official transaction with this office. So, kanang mag-recommend bitaw ta o example doon na naka-kay position sa opisina or head or mga supervisor baka. And then doon na siya ay pending na ginapaluap niya sa imo. And then, recommend ka somebody, recommend ka o friend o kinsa ba na mag-work dito sa iya ha or certain office na gamito niyo ang imang kaning pagka kaning imo habitong posisyon aron makatabang ka nga to sa uban. So, dili na siya maayo. No? Especially kung doon ay ginapaluap sa imong opisina na mag-take advantage po. So, dili na siya maayo. Dili na po siya dapat kinuuna. Next, soliciting or accepting directly or indirectly any gift, gratuity, favor, entertainment, loan, or anything of monetary value which in the course of his official duties or in connection with any operation being regulated by or any transaction which may be affected by the function of this office. So, kanang magdawat ka o gift or para paspasan ni magdawat ka o gift kay doon na siya ginapaluap or ingon nila para madali ang imo ang ginapaluap sa uban. So, dili na siya maayo. Doon ay okay na daw magdawat o gift sa civil service bitaw sa one time doon na may seminar. Pero gift murag doon na po siya limit ba kung nahumana o trabaho nimo ang iyang gipahimo or na doon na libitaw kay kanang na produce nga gihimo nimo sa ihang kana mo dag kuan na lang to siya kana pahalipay ba nga so pwede ra nimo to dawaton pero kon tagaan ka og something para paspasan nimo og trabaho to kana ang dili maayo no so pwede ra damo ga dawat og gift pero dili daw pwede mo ga dawat og lagay so unsa may difference daw anang gift og lagay no para tong na istorya nga gidad-an siya sa iyang client niya sa unsa man ni kani gift or lagay siya lagay na sir kay na man siya ginakaluwa siya dili ra ba mi mudawat og lagay taod-taod mutana na po siya wala pa man to niya gidawat siya unsa man na ba kani gift or lagay ingon nang tungod tao gift sir ay sige pwede ni siya so unsa may difference daw sa gift or lagay no kani pareha lang kon labi na dunay ginapaluap niya dili ni himo kung wala ihatag diya sa inyo. Okay, last RA is 9845 Anti-Red Tape Act of 2007 signed into law by President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo on June 2, 2007 rules as an ethical basis. Okay, atin yung basahon. Refusal to accept application and or request within the prescribed period or any document being submitted by a client. And then, failure to act on an application and or request or failure to refer back to the client a request which cannot be acted upon due to lack of requirements within the prescribed period. So kung muna ang client sa tua, kailangan doon na tayo ka ng checklist ba sa requirements. Aron nga, dili pa, balik-balik po nato ang client. Aron ka ng pag-anha niya, ready na tanan kung unsa ang ikinhangla nato ng mga requirements. Next is failure to attend the to clients who are within the premises of the office agency concerned prior to end official working hours and during lunch break. So, while ang clients na din ha, ikaw po, lakaw-lakaw, o atin umili, kaya naman importante. So, tagaan na tuog panahon sila na naadiya sa opisina. Kung naaraman po kaniya sa office premises. Failure to render frontline service within the prescribed period on any application and or request without due cause. Next is failure to give the client a written notice on the disapproval of an application or request. So, mo na nga kanang usahay magsigid gulat bisan in the office gani kita no sa opisina mismo magsigid ta gulat sa ato ang ginapalo sa ato ang gipaluwat nga tuwa dito sa lain nga department pero wala ta kabalo nga duda day problema so dapat imuli to nimo usupian nimo kon unsa di kailangan so imposition of additional relevant requirements other listed on the first notice so maka-experience po ta nini mato taglain nga opisina na yung mga additional requirements nga wala gihatag nila sa ilang lista. So, dili ka na siya maayo. Grave offense, fixing, or and or collusion with fixers in consideration of economic and or other gain or advantage. So, mahimot ang fixer diya sa opisina. Tabangan ta ka na, dali ka na siya na. Hindi ta kagpamaagi kasi pisuhito ka diya sa office. Pero with ka ng in return ba nga magpabayad ka so kung dili kana po siya maayo mas maayo pa nga mutabang ka without kanang help ng bitaw nga kanang from your heart na gusto ka mutabang dili na magpabayad kanang fixer no kailangan maguna na mo demog mao na pud ang ilahang means of living maka-income pud sila okay unlawful acts ang atong natun-an. One is RA-3019, graft and corruption or malversation. Next is RA-6713, katong code of conduct, no? Pecuniary interest. Pecuniary is related to money na siya. So conflict of interest, nepotism. And then so RA-9485 is red tape. So here, naigiingon diri nga, unethical behavior is not necessarily illegal, but nevertheless is contrary to what is right and doing what is not right. So, not all things that are legal are moral. Unethical behavior, ang iyang mudaw niya siya sa Yale's adverse resort, violates the norms of relationships and traditions, and then the service to the government or kanang harmful to the government and the people and bad image of the government. So, doon na din yung slides nga itong makita nga giingon, di bawal pero di dapat. Okay, ito ni siyang ilang taon. Nadiri, si Jessica Soho. Di bawal pero di dapat. So, isa nini is Padrino System. So, diha sa ato ang opisina. Whom you know, kung may backer, best friend, or relatives, ang head of office. So, murag, video na malikaya, no? Part na po na sa kuan dia sa games. So di pero di siya bawal pero di dapat padrino system. Sa mag-anak system. Nanatanan, although di siya recommending or kaning approving authority nga siya jud ang mag-approve sa mga appointment. Pero kini bitaw ang mga uban nga na lang sa ubos nga hapit na lang tanan yang ingon nila iro na lang ang wala na kasulod sa DNR. So, na diya ang pag-umangkon, iyang mga kasin, nungay mo nana, so, kamag-anak system. Sani is wastage of office supplies and equipment. So, kung ma-recycle na to ang atong gamit sa office, like kaning paper clips, or kaning mga band paper na sa likod, pwede pag magamit para mag-draft, no? So ato na siyang gamiton dili nga ilabay dayon. Next is engaging in group discussion while clients are keep waiting. So inauta nga dili ni mahitabo sa tong opisina no nga while na igahulat and sila pod sige chika-chika. So before do na ko nakit-an nga murag dili may kun siya lang taon kay nasa opisina magpa-pedicure, manicure. So, during office hour, ha? So, dili siya, bad example siya, dili siya maayo lang tawon sa, labi na, daghantag mga bago, no, kanang mga contract of service. So, na, one time, doon ay contract of service na, na GO nga, akong isaway, kabang siya, katugan ni O, gitulo niya itong mga karaan ng mga, kwan, employees, kay mo, kung doon lang bihin mo, pedicure, manicure during office hour. Oh, so dili siya dapat himuon nato. Kay mahimutang dili may mga ehemplo sa mga bag-o sa mga young ones. This one is tilibabad. So wala dili naman ta, dili ni siya updated kay kasagaran karon cellphone naman ta. So dili during office hour dapat dili nato gamiton ang atong time sa sige og call, sige tawag, sige chat. So kung sige ka gingon na magdito na lang ka sa kaning call center, mag-work. So reminder lang naman po ni siya, no? Mga kauban sa work, reminder lang po ni kay isay, at itagahin mo po ni ini para reminder lang po ni sa kanang kada isa sa tua. Too much texting during office hours. Too much reading newspapers during office hours. So parang mga wala naman kahit aning newspaper, no? Dito na lang tagalantaw sa YouTube, sa ito ang mga gadgets. Pwede na po na parelax, panalag sa pero kailangan himuunin mo ang imuhang ato ang assigned task. Going out of the office without permission. So, muna sibat-sibat, dili manahid sa iyang supervisor. So, dili siya, maayo dapat kailangan na kay permiso. Kay unsay na kay pass out sila, kay unsay may tabo sa imo ha sa gawas, wala kay mahimo, wala man ka, di man official lang imo or personal, wala kay pass out nga napirmahan sa imong bossing. This one is loping, magsuroy-suroy, imbis to sa work, to agalag-lag sa lain nga table hopping, o niya makadistorb po ka nga to sa uban nga naang tay work. Okay, inappropriate attire. So kita ninyo dili ni siya. Later do natay discussion briefly about any of appropriate attire sa office. Constant clock watching. So sige lang taw sa iyang dilo siguro do na date. Pwede naman po na maglantaw sa atong reloto. Ang ingon mga baby is constant clock watching. Ang imuhang work, pinin mo mabantayan tungod na ma-work, mahimo tungod kay naagsigin na lang ka o at tang sa imuhang urasan. Extended break. So, ang time diri is 1:15. Pero haya, nagpakuan pa siya. Nag-rest no, sa iyahang mag-extend niya iyahang break. So, diri, dress code prescribed for all government officials and employees. CAC number 14 and 25 series of 1991. In line with the provision of RE 6713, Code of Conduct and Ethical Standard for Public Officials and Employees, and in order to maintain modesty and proper decorum in the civil service, the Civil Service Commission, being the central personnel agency of the government, hereby prescribe the following as the dress code for all government officials and employees in the government service when reporting for work. Thus, number one, the office uniforms as prescribed by the different government agencies, offices, shall be the official attire of all government officials and employees, which shall be worn in accordance with their assigned schedule. Two, appropriate attire. On those days when there is no prescribed office uniform for the day, employees shall be dressed in appropriate business attire. The wearing of maong pants, although generally prohibited, may be considered as appropriate attire when paired with a collared polo shirt for male employees or any appropriate blouse or shirt for female employees. So ang maong, pwede na siya, pero parisan kunin mo o kanang polo shirt or kanang doon na bitaw siya ikwilyo or para sa babae po kanang appropriate na blouse or shirt. Three, prohibited attire. The following attire shall be prohibited for all government employees when performing officials function, official functions inside the workplace. Glossy, transparent or net-like shirt or blouse. Sando, strapless or spaghetti strap blouse. Unless worn as an undershirt. Tank tops blouse with over-plunging necklace. Kanabitang necklines. Kanabitang sa mga babae nga open kayo dili sa dughan nga pag ana nimo maklaro na ang cleavage. So di na siya mayo. Or nipis nga blouse, nga t-shirt o blouse na imong pagkasulubon nga marka na kung para sa mga female nga marka na ang kaning imong bra or ang mga lalaki po nagpurma ng ilang boobs, no? Muna na nipis na transparent. Micro mini skirt, walking shorts, cycling shorts, leggings, tights, jogging pants. And then rubber sandals, rubber slippers or bakya. So dili naman yung uso kini nga panahon siguro uso pang bakya. So karon wala na wala nang bakya. Pero dili dapat diha sa opisina labi na usay magbalon bitaw ta og slipper. Katungkon mura po siya og sandal-sandal. Dili pod nga katang sanilas pangbalay ang atong gamiton, no? And then other prohibitions. The following shall also be prohibited during office hours and with other premises. Within other premises. Tentatious display of jewelry. Except for special occasions and during official celebrations. So daghan kayo ka og mga jewelries. Imong sing-sing panilip and right. No? Dayon, pila ka tudlo, gibutangan. Wearing of heavy and theatrical makeup, so mura kag clown. It is likewise to considered as a taboo to use curlers, turbans, bandanas during office hours and within office premises. Okay, exemption. Doon na po siya exemptions. That may be allowed in the implementation of this dress code. Certain exemptions may be allowed on the following grounds. when the nature of work of the official employee demands that he or she wears clothing other than those prescribed above. So kung mag-field work, so okay, masulog po ka sa imuhang pang-field work po. Masulog mo t-shirt, dili po ka mag-uniform. Kaya init po kayo, di po ka comfortable. When religious affiliation or creed or any legitimate practice by the employee in relation thereto requires him here to wear a particular clothing. And then physical disabilities and other legitimate health reasons. Pregnant female employees are allowed to wear maternity dress during the period of their pregnancy. Employees who lost a loved ones can one can wear mourning clothes during the period of mourning and other circumstances analogous to the foregoing. Okay, penalty in case of violation. So sa office at kuna niya uniform, so do na po'y penalty. Any violation of the provisions of this dress code shall be considered as ground for disciplinary action. For violation of reasonable office rules and regulations under section 22.C, rule 14, revised omnibus rules implementing book 5 of the administrative code of 1987, executive order number 292. Thus, subject to the requirements of due process, the following penalties shall be strictly imposed in administrative disciplinary proceeding for non-compliance with the guidelines. One, a first offense, reprimand. So, kanang supian ka o kasaban ka. Supian ka, remind ka sa HR. Second offense, suspension for 1 day to 30 days. Third offense, suspension for 2 months. And the last offense is dismissal from the service. So pwede gali siya ma-dismissal kining kung nabilong mangguna siya sa kaning office rules and regulation, no? For violation of reasonable office rules and regulation. So, careful lang po kita, no? So, now, kaning before sa last two slides na lang, akong pasalamatan daan ang inyong pagpaminaw. Unawat nga, kaning nalapon mo yung na-learn, no, sa ato ang mubo nga lecture karon. Kung dili man tanan, ato lang remember ang ato ang guiding principles, rules and moral obligation as public servants. So dinay giingon diri nga remember kitang tanan from the pinakaubos, butang nato mga janitor or utility workers or mga head of the department, section, division or office, we have the job to perform for the best interest of our Filipinos. So, dunay word of reminder dini from our one of our famous president in our country, President Manuel L. Quezon. So, ako ning basahon, every officials of the government, even the most modest, has a job to perform and is as much in duty bound to perform the job well as those occupying higher positions. In our effort to give the people the best government that there is, we have to have everybody do his job, including the clerk, the policeman, everybody in the service. So every one of them should do his best because a government cannot be a government of higher officials only. So from President Manuel L. Quezon. So thank you and God bless us all.